Hey guys, welcome to my channel. When it comes to mega projects, Chinese engineers have been globally renowned for their astonishing construction speed and the incredible projects they undertake. Chinese engineers are like superheroes in the field of construction, actively contributing to the country's infrastructure development by constructing massive projects to accommodate the country's growing population and rapidly advancing economy and technology. In recent years, with the rapid development of the economy and technology, China's emphasis on infrastructure construction has been continuously increasing, earning the country the humorous nickname of Infrastructure Maniac internationally. This title is not derogatory, rather, it reflects the awe of Americans towards China's infrastructure construction. China has transitioned from severely lagging in infrastructure to being labeled an Infrastructure Maniac in just a few decades. Over these years, China has constructed numerous large-scale projects that deeply impact the lives of its people, as well as the development of its economy and society. In the past 30 years, China's pace of modernization has surpassed that of any other country globally, achieving remarkable accomplishments in infrastructure that have left the world in awe. These megaprojects are so impressive that foreigners often say China has mastered future technology. So, which infrastructure projects have garnered such praise from foreigners? In this video, we will uncover the stories and factors behind China's construction of giant engineering projects. But before we delve into the discussion, we sincerely ask for your support. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel. Your thoughts are crucial to us, and we invite you to share your opinions in the comments below. Without further ado, let's embark on an extraordinary journey. Let's start exploring China's mega projects that have reshaped the country. Bayan River Bridge. The vertical height of the bridge deck above the Bayan River reaches an impressive 565.4 meters. The tips of the towers reach 750 meters above the valley floor, higher than two Eiffel Towers and the Statue of Liberty combined. Currently the world's tallest cable-stayed bridge with a steel truss, it proudly holds the title of the world's highest bridge. In terms of grandeur, it surpasses even the iconic San Francisco Golden Gate Bridge. The 20,000-ton steel bridge deck is the length of five Titanics. When China announced its plan to invest 1 billion yuan in the construction of the Bayan River Bridge, American experts predicted it would take China 300 years to complete this monumental project. To everyone's amazement, Chinese engineers defied expectations and completed the colossal undertaking at an unimaginable speed, leaving the once mocking American experts silenced.
Oh God, please no! No!
In reality, it took only 3 years for China to successfully finish the Bayan River Bridge. One can only wonder how long it might have taken if the project were undertaken by the United States. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. The rugged terrain and extremely poor transportation conditions in the Guizhou region had a profound negative impact on the local population's economic development. Therefore, in 2013, China decided to construct a world record-breaking bridge at the intersection of Yunnan and Guizhou provinces to completely transform Guizhou's harsh transportation environment. However, this plan faced mockery from Western bridge expert Smith. With a height of 565 meters, equivalent to 200 floors, surpassing even the tallest US structure, the World Trade Center at 412 meters, foreign media rushed to report on the seemingly impossible project. Smith, after inspecting the Beipanjiang Grand Canyon, asserted that even with American technology, it would take 300 years to complete, suggesting China would need at least 3,000 years. Despite the ridicule, Chinese engineers courageously faced the challenge, determined to make Beipanjiang the world's highest bridge. However, the engineering team was undeterred by external mockery and dedicated themselves wholeheartedly to the construction. Situated in a canyon with a main bridge length of 1341 meters, traditional bridge pier construction in the canyon was impossible. Considering wind risks, the construction team opted for cable-stayed bridge technology. During construction, Chinese engineers innovatively employed longitudinal movement and hanging assembly techniques for the first time, lifting and assembling the 12-meter, approximately 160-ton steel trusses in midair. Precision alignment of 27mm diameter bolts was essential. Despite the fierce canyon winds, Chinese engineers overcame every challenge, demonstrating their ability to tackle any obstacle. To address challenges like impassable rivers for traditional ship transport of cut-off beams, engineers adopted new methods. Beams were disassembled into smaller pieces, transported to the site by trucks, and assembled like building blocks, accelerating the installation process, shortening the construction period, and reducing damage to the bridge piers. Additionally, for the steel cables lifting the bridge deck, China's engineering team used one of the strongest materials with a compressive strength exceeding 1860 MPa and a dynamic load yield strength reaching 250 MPa. This material greatly ensured the stability of the bridge under strong winds and water vapor erosion, guaranteeing the project's safety. We see the deck of the Beipan River Grand Bridge connected to its towers, with steel cables spanning 250 feet, enough to stretch from New York City to Washington, D.C. To construct this unprecedented architectural marvel, Chinese engineers had to tackle numerous challenging engineering feats. The bridge spans the isolated depths of the Guizhou Grand Canyon, making it an epic engineering endeavor. Between two iconic towers, it stretches over a mile-long deck. Supported by 250-foot steel cables, it carries an incredible 22,000 tons of weight. This bridge can arguably be deemed the most colossal bridge structure on this planet. Through this project, China not only showcased its strength, providing effective support for poverty alleviation projects in Guizhou and Yunnan, but also defeated foreign experts who once mocked China. In fact, even the United States, with its arrogant statements about China, couldn't guarantee the completion of the Beipan River Bridge. This bridge stands as a milestone in China's infrastructure development, serving as an irreplaceable transportation hub. In 2016, with a cost of 1 billion yuan and a construction time of 3 years, the Beipan River Bridge, standing at a height of 565.4 meters, successfully set a new Guinness World Record. China's achievement completely contradicted the initial mockery from the famous American bridge expert Smith, who claimed it would take at least 3,000 years to complete. Located in the central part of the Yunnan-Guizhou Plateau, overcoming steep terrain and complex geology, the Beipan River Bridge has shortened the travel time between Yunnan and Guizhou to just 1 hour, bringing new hope to this land and becoming a source of pride in China's bridge construction. The completion of the Beipan River Bridge signifies another miracle in the history of global engineering. Huangshan Overpass. The Huangshan Overpass is the most intricate overpass in the world. When viewed from above, one can see a dense network of roads. This overpass consists of 5 layers of structure, with as many as 20 ramps extending in 8 directions. These roads intertwine like routes, making it difficult for even seasoned drivers to find their way down if driving onto the overpass for the first time. It's no wonder it's been dubbed by foreigners as capable of making even navigation systems surrender. 3. Gorges Dam. The Three Gorges Dam is the largest hydroelectric power project in the world today, serving as the largest hydroelectric power station and a major hub for clean energy production globally. The total construction volume of the main structure of the Three Gorges Water Control Project is beyond imagination, with 102.83 million cubic meters of excavation for the foundation, 27.94 million cubic meters of concrete foundation, 31.98 million cubic meters of earth and rock filling, 256,500 tons of metal structure installation, and the installation of 34 sets of units with a capacity of 22.5 million kilowatts for the hydropower station. Except for earth and rock filling, all other indicators rank first in the world. The Three Gorges project has three main benefits, namely flood control, power generation, and navigation, with flood control considered the core benefit of the project. The navigation ship lock of the Three Gorges project is 6.4 kilometers long in total, with the main part of the ship lock being 1.6 kilometers long. It consists of double lines of five-tier ship locks, making it the largest of its kind in the world, and possesses the greatest water level drop among ship locks worldwide. When the Indian Prime Minister saw the Three Gorges Dam project, he instantly lost his composure. In order to surpass China, they hired Japanese experts at high salaries, vowing to build a dam even more impressive than the Three Gorges Dam. However, they ended up with a slap in the face. They invested 220 billion rupees and spent 42 years, finally completing the dam in Jharkhand. But that day also became its anniversary of doom, as the dam collapsed just 4 seconds after it was opened. So, for India to think it can surpass China is simply wishful thinking. China's Sky Eye. China's significant scientific infrastructure, the 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope, known as the Eye of China and named FAST in English, lives up to its name with its fast and highly sensitive observation capabilities. Located in Pingtang County, Guizhou Province, the Eye of China has a diameter of over 500 meters, equivalent to the size of 30 standard football fields. It outperforms the previously most advanced Arecibo Observatory in the United States. Unfortunately, due to the lack of funding and maintenance by the U.S. government, the Arecibo Observatory telescope collapsed completely on the morning of December 1, 2020, after years of neglect. With this, the era of the Arecibo Observatory Telescope, once a superhero in the world of astronomy, has come to an end. It is now replaced by China's 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope. For FAST, a foreign expert gave high praise, considering the telescope to be a powerful tool for astronomers and one of the most significant contributions made by Chinese scientists, playing a significant role in future astronomical endeavors worldwide. During operation, the 500-meter aperture spherical telescope has observed more pulsars than the total observed by European and American countries, and has even captured extremely rare astronomical phenomena. As a crucial instrument in the Chinese astronomical field, FAST has not only broken the constraints on the development of China's astronomical endeavors, but will also play an even more significant role in the future, achieving more splendid accomplishments. The National Stadium of China, also known as the Bird's Nest, is situated in the southern part of the central area of the Beijing Olympic Park. It served as the main stadium for the 2008 Beijing Olympics, witnessing an unparalleled Summer Olympics. Covering a total area of 21 hectares, the main structure is an elliptical nest-shaped steel truss, 333 meters long from north to south, 296 meters wide from east to west, and reaching a maximum height of 69 meters. The stadium has approximately 91,000 seats. Construction commenced in December 2003 and was completed in June 2008, earning it the title of one of the 10 architectural wonders of the world in 2007. It also hosted the opening and closing ceremonies of the Beijing Winter Olympics, making it the first venue in history to host both the Summer and Winter Olympics opening and closing ceremonies. The bird's nest has become an iconic symbol representing China, imbued with a more sacred and profound significance, marking a milestone in the history of world architecture and serving as a historical witness to the architectural development of China and the world in the 21st century. The Canton Tower, located at the intersection of the new central axis of Guangzhou City and the Pearl River landscape axis, boasts a total height of 600 meters, with the main tower standing at 450 meters and the antenna reaching 150 meters. The outer framework consists of 24 steel columns and 46 steel elliptical rings intersecting to create a unique hollow and open beauty, seemingly twisting and transforming in three-dimensional space. As the world's tallest building with the slimmest waist and the most difficult construction, construction began in November 2005 and was completed in September 2009. The Canton Tower is a classic architectural masterpiece constructed from over 10,000 steel components of varying sizes and angles, creating a series of world records in architecture, including the world's tallest outdoor observation deck and the world's highest thrilling descent. At the top of the tower is the world's highest horizontal Ferris wheel and 16 crystal sightseeing capsules, offering spectacular views of the Pearl River and the dazzling night scenery of Guangzhou. Beijing Daxing International Airport is located between Daxing District of Beijing and Guangyang District of Hebei Province, at the core area of the Beijing-Tianjin-Hebei region, serving as a super-large international aviation hub. Designed and constructed to accommodate a passenger throughput of 100 million and 800,000 aircraft movements annually, the airport is built in two phases. Phase 1 features four runways covering an area of 27 square kilometers, with a designed annual cargo throughput of 2 million tons and a passenger volume of 72 million. By 2040, the airport will add two more runways, bringing the total to six, covering an area of 68 square kilometers, with an annual cargo throughput of 4 million tons and a passenger volume exceeding 100 million. The terminal covers an area of 1.43 million square meters, designed with the passenger experience in mind, resembling a spreading phoenix, making it the world's largest airport terminal with 137 jet bridges. Beijing Daxing International Airport officially commenced operations in September 2019, hailed as the first of the new seven wonders of the world. The journey through China's mega projects is one of awe and inspiration, a testament to human ingenuity, innovation, and the relentless pursuit of progress. Each of China's major projects showcases the remarkable feats that can be achieved when vision, technology, and sheer determination come together. If you found this video insightful, give it a thumbs up and share it with others. We would love to hear your thoughts and insights in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated with more fascinating content. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Let's continue to explore, learn, and inspire together. Take care and goodbye.